Anyway, it is time for some unusual stories from around the globe. Yes, that's right. It's what you're here. Do what the television says. All right, a Chinese man has offered $190,000 for a date with a virgin. Ooh. No, it is not a guy who sits up all night playing War and Warcraft. It is a woman who has to be under 25, over 1.68 metres tall, weigh less than 50 kilograms. I take it Jess Rowe and Cathy Lett are not applying, and have a bachelor's degree.
I'm halfway there.
Which half?
Well, you're not married. You're not married yet, Seth.
Let's have a drive.
I don't have a bachelor's degree.
That's just revolting.
The post was put on China's leading social network site from an account called Heiwen, from an account called Host of Henan. So there you go, in China, no Facebook, but you can buy and sell women. Isn't that nice?
I think we'd have to say that's virgin on the ridiculous. Number one.
Richard Branson is currently trying to buy the rights, going, I wish I'd thought of that. Over to Japan now. They have created a bra that automatically opens when a wearer is aroused. So obviously not a problem I'm ever going to encounter. It comes with a heart rate monitor that automatically unhooks the bra when your pulse hits the so-called true love rate.
Well, what if you're just jogging and your pulse rate goes
up? Apparently, I'm glad you asked, Cathy. The maker insists that the bra will not automatically burst open when the wearer goes for a jog. It says the application can recognise the difference between a heart rate spike caused by exercise compared to a heart rate spike caused by true love.
Also, if you're with a guy whose IQ is so small he doesn't know how to undo your bra, I think that might be a contraceptive
Everyone talks to each other, you know, and it says, you know, how do you know if it's the one? How do you know if it's the one? And now you just go, how do I know if he really loves me for myself?
My cups runneth over with love,
Oh, my God, that's funny. Two puns in the... Anyway, and finally, it is good to know what soldiers really get up to in their spare time. These are Swedish Marines during service in Afghanistan.
That is good curry.
It's like the Swedes answer to Abu Ghraib. That is 3 for 3. That is a hat-trick of puns from Cathy Lett. But I think that somewhere in the bunch of soldiers doing a musical number perhaps lies a clue as to why Sweden is no longer the revered military force it once was.
Could you imagine, like, the Taliban standing there watching
would hate it because they're not dancing's banned under the Taliban. Right, okay. So probably that is a lethal weapon.
Oh, my God, they are defeating us with their music. The infidels win again. I only have one accent, and it covers terrorists, Canadians, New Zealanders, and Arnold Schwarzenegger.